Hi, I am Oscar Huarac, your missionary to Peru, South America. As Jesus met in the upper room with his disciples, he encouraged their saddened hearts. He had just told them of his departure and that they couldn't follow him. But then he gave them a very great promise. We read in John chapter 14, 25 and 26. These things I have spoken to you while being present with you. But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all things that I said to you. Jesus promised to send the Holy Spirit to give his disciples understanding when he would no longer be with them in this world. It is also the Holy Spirit that makes us as believers understand the mind of God. In addition, Jesus promised his disciples peace. Verse 27 says, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. And what does the God's word tell us about that peace promised by Christ? We read in Romans chapter 5, verses 10 and 11, and says, "For if, when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, much more, having been reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. And not only that, but that also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received the reconciliation. It is therefore impossible to experience the peace of God if we do not have peace with God. That is precisely what the Lord Jesus Christ accomplished through his death on Calvary's cross. We are no longer God's enemies. God's Holy Spirit is in the hearts of believers, giving understanding of his inspired word. We cannot experience the peace of God apart from the word of God. But the same Spirit who came to the apostles and gave them understanding of all Christ had said and done is in us as well. As believers, we can now understand his word and his work on the cross. This ability to understand the gospel of Jesus Christ brings us the peace of God that passes all understanding. May you bathe in his peace today.